Our devices contain a treasure trove of private information. We have sensitive work documents, cherished family photos, archives of private communications. How do we keep all these important files safe? In this video, we're going to explain the benefits of encrypted containers, which are secure digital vaults for your files that will help keep your data private. We'll look specifically at the free open source encryption program VeraCrypt and show you how to set it up. In the middle of the video, we do dive into the weeds a little to explain how volumes are mounted and how file directories work for those who are interested. So if you just want the tutorial, feel free to skip ahead. We'll get started by understanding the use cases of encrypted containers. Let's imagine that our computer is a locked room in our house. Your room might be pretty secure, but you can make your important assets even more secure by having a safe inside the room. That way, even if you leave the door to the room open, your assets are still protected. An encrypted container is like a safe inside a locked room. Your computer may be locked up tight, but if it's ever opened, your important files are safely stored behind an additional encryption layer. What might you use an encrypted container for? Well, if you have any sensitive documents, you can store them here. Things like local password managers, contacts lists, family photos. Also, there are many apps on your computer that might demand access to your desktop or docs folder or downloads. You can put the files that you don't want these apps to see inside one of these encrypted containers. Or perhaps you need to store some files on a USB thumb drive. If you accidentally lose this thumb drive, you don't want some stranger to be able to pick it up and get access to your files. Storing them inside an encrypted folder on the USB stick, or even encrypting the entire volume, protects them. You might also have some files you need to upload to the cloud. By encrypting them first and then uploading them, you are keeping them far more secure. Then there are higher threat models that some people might consider. These days, many of us have computers with encrypted hard drives already. This is a great first step to protecting our data, and it makes it very hard for someone to access it. If your device is powered down and someone gets physical access to it, it's almost impossible for them to access your data. But if the computer is just sleeping, it can be slightly easier for someone to access your data, if they're particularly skilled. Let me explain. With an encrypted hard drive, all the data on your computer is encrypted. When you power on your device, all that data remains encrypted until you first enter your password or decryption key. Once you do this, the device is able to decrypt the data. The decryption key is then stored in RAM, which is a type of computer memory that stores data being actively used by the computer. This allows the computer to decrypt data for you as you work. The RAM is wiped when you power off your device, which will wipe that password. But simply putting it to sleep doesn't clear the RAM, which means your password is still sitting there. So someone with a very high skill set might be able to take that sleeping computer and lift the password out of RAM. So if you have files that are more important than the rest of the things on your hard drive, and you don't want the device to always have access to them when you're working, you can put them behind an additional encryption layer. One tool you can use to create encrypted containers is VeraCrypt. It's really cool, free and open source encryption software, and I first learned about it from Michael Basil in his book Extreme Privacy. VeraCrypt allows you to create virtual encrypted volumes, or containers, that can securely store any type of file. Once you put a file into the container, you can think of the contents of the container as being scrambled, and only the person who has the password will be able to unscramble them. So even if someone manages to get their hands on your device, whether it's lost, stolen, or seized, they won't be able to read these files without the encryption password. VeraCrypt offers many different encryption algorithms for you to encrypt your data, and it uses a method known as on-the-fly encryption, or transparent encryption. This means that it's encrypting and decrypting data in real time as it's accessed or written, without any noticeable delay for the user. So data is automatically encrypted when saved to the container and decrypted when read, all without the user needing to manually perform these actions each time. The entire encrypted container or volume is mounted as a virtual drive. What does this mean? Well, an actual physical drive is something like this. You plug it in, and when it's mounted, you see it pop up as a separate location on Mac or with a drive letter on Windows. Mounting a device is how an operating system makes files and directories on a storage device like a hard drive or USB stick accessible to the user. And it basically means that it's assigned a location in the directory tree so that you can read, write, and manage files within this volume. Mounting is also how your operating system makes encrypted containers accessible to the user. You might have your encrypted container sitting on your desktop, but when you provide the correct encryption key inside VeraCrypt, VeraCrypt will mount the encrypted volume and it will show up as a separate virtual volume. So on Windows, it will be assigned a virtual drive letter like E, or on macOS, it will be assigned a mount point like volume/encrypted volume. Once it's mounted, you can access the files within the encrypted volume just like they were on a regular drive. If your encrypted container is actually on a separate physical drive, both the physical drive and the encrypted volume will show up as volumes. VeraCrypt is incredible software that also offers even more advanced features for more sophisticated threats. For example, you can create a hidden encrypted volume within your main container so that if you're forced to open your container, no one will know that there is a further hidden volume inside the container, accessible with a different password. So here's how to install VeraCrypt and create an encrypted container. The software works on macOS, Windows, and Linux computers, and the process is very similar on each. First, download VeraCrypt from their website. Then open the installer and begin the install process. You can generally accept all the default settings for this part. If you have a Mac computer, there are some extra steps that you'll now have to perform, which we'll go through. So if you don't have a Mac computer, feel free to skip ahead. I'm also going to detour here to explain file systems if you did want to stick around. So on Mac computers, when you click the VeraCrypt installer, you'll get a pop-up telling you to install something called Mac Fuse, or sometimes called OS X Fuse. Fuse stands for File System in User Space. A file system is a data structure that an operating system uses to manage and organize files, handling how data is stored, retrieved, and updated. Etc. Normally, file systems are created in something called the kernel, which is a central component of an operating system, and it acts as a bridge between applications and the hardware of a computer. Usually, code running in the kernel space has full access to hardware and can execute any CPU instruction. MacFuse is a software package that you can use to create file systems on macOS that run in the user space rather than within the kernel. This means that they run as normal applications with limited privileges, which can be better for stability and security. The software will also allow your Mac operating system to communicate with these user space file systems. VeraCrypt is going to need to create file systems in user space, so that's why you'll first need to install the MacFuse software. Okay, explainer over. VeraCrypt has the MacFuse software linked on their website under the macOS download options. Click the OS X Fuse link and you'll arrive at their GitHub. Download the DMG file under Assets and run the installer. You may get a message in the installer telling you to open your privacy and security system settings. Click on the button or go to System Preferences and Security and Privacy. Click Enable System Extensions. You may get another pop-up telling you that you first need to modify your security extensions in the recovery environment. What this means is you have to restart your computer in recovery mode and change some settings. To do this, shut down your computer normally and then press and hold the power button. This will boot your computer in recovery mode. Go to Options, log into your user, under Utilities, select Startup Security Utility, then click on the Security Policy button. You'll have an option to select Full Security, where you only allow Apple trusted software to run, or Reduced Security, enabling user management of kernel extensions from identified users. You will need to choose Reduced Security to allow the MacFuse software to run, and you'll check the first box. As the name suggests, this option may decrease overall system security by permitting potentially less vetted software to run, so you should be mindful to only install trusted extensions and maintain good security practices, because Apple will no longer block non-trusted software for you. Now, restart your Mac normally, and then start the MacFuse installation process again. you'll probably get the same warning saying that your system extension has been blocked. Open System Preferences, and where it says that system software from Benjamin Fleischer has been blocked, click Allow. Your MacFuse installation is now complete, and once it's done, you can install VeraCrypt on your machine. Once VeraCrypt is installed, launch the program. Click on the Create Volume button to get started. From here, you'll have two options. First is to create an encrypted file container. Think of this like a portable folder, and any file placed inside of it becomes encrypted as part of the container. This is a good option for anyone who wants to easily be able to transfer encrypted containers between different devices or storage mediums. Since it's just a file, it can be used on any operating system where VeraCrypt is available. The second option is to encrypt a non-system partition or drive. This method encrypts all the data on a partition or drive and is particularly suitable for large data storage. You might choose this option if you want to secure an external hard drive that stores all backup data, ensuring that the entire drive is encrypted and protected. If you're unsure which to choose, go with a file container. You can put many files inside this encrypted container as long as you have space. Next, we'll select volume type, either a standard encrypted volume or a hidden one. We're going to go with standard for this tutorial, and we'll explain hidden volumes in a follow-up video. Choose a location for your container. This might be on your hard drive, or it could be on a connected USB stick or external hard drive. Note that you don't want to select an existing file or folder, because VeraCrypt will delete this existing file or folder and replace it with a new encrypted empty container. Instead, you want to just choose a location where your container should be located and give it a name. Next, select the encryption algorithm that you want to use. Unless you have a specific reason to choose otherwise, the default AES encryption is a good option. Choose the size of the container. Have a think about how much data you want to be able to move into this encrypted container as your guide. Now is a super important step. Set your password. People often use really weak passwords that are common words with maybe an added character or number at the end. Don't do this. So, how long should your password be? Here's a good guide from Hive Systems. If you have a long and complex enough password, it can take current computing power millions or even billions of years to crack. Have a password generator create a long random string, and make sure you store that password safely. This password is the gatekeeper to your sensitive data, so it's essential that you choose something sufficiently complex and you keep it safe. Once you've completed these steps, VeraCrypt will begin the process of encrypting your container. Depending on the size of the volume and the performance of your device, this may take some time. Then click Format, and your encrypted VeraCrypt container is ready to use. To start using your container, you'll launch VeraCrypt and see a bunch of empty slots. Highlight any of them to mount your encrypted container into. Select the file that you just created and click Mount. Type in your password, and the encrypted container will be decrypted and mounted in the slot that you selected, with all contents accessible just like any of your normal files, available for you to access. It will show up mounted just like your other drives, and you can also access it by double-clicking on the slot in VeraCrypt. The container will initially be empty. If you want to encrypt documents or files in the future, you'll just move them into the container. You now possess a powerful tool to safeguard your most sensitive digital assets, whether it's confidential work documents, personal photos, or the keys to your online accounts. Your data is now shielded from prying eyes, even if your device falls into the wrong hands. The benefits of VeraCrypt go beyond just protecting your own information. It also preserves the privacy of everyone whose data may be stored within your encrypted containers. So if you need to store other people's data for your work, protecting this data in an encrypted container is a great idea. If you find VeraCrypt useful, I encourage you to donate to their developers. It's a free tool, and they rely on donations to keep it maintained. They accept a bunch of different currencies, including cryptocurrencies. Our personal data is the currency of the modern surveillance world. Locking away our personal files behind an encrypted barrier is not just a luxury. It's a necessity. NBTV is also donation-based. We are a non-profit research and media institute that investigates privacy tools and creates helpful tutorials to show you how to use them. If you want to help us create more tutorials like this one, visit nbtv.media/support to set up a monthly tax-deductible donation. We also have a free newsletter where we send out additional privacy tips each week. And did you know that this t-shirt is also available to purchase in our merch store? I think you'd look great in it. It all goes towards helping support what we do. Thank you for helping us out.